the Vatican Council, which went from 1962 to 1965. A boys' choir was formed here in Madrid by David Rankin, of which I was a member from 1963 until 1967. There was a bit of an incident out there in the pious objects at all, and I didn't like someone there, but that's a boys will be boys. The organist was the late Stuart Conroy. There he is. He looks like he was also another wish now. Stuart is both sadly deceased. Musically speaking, these were exciting times for Australian Catholic composers of sacred music, with so many beautiful English hymns and masses being composed. And an outstanding composer is Richard Connolly, whose timeless hymns are sung in churches around Australia to this very day. And it was wonderful to see so much of Richard's repertoire performed for World Youth Day in 2008. And I was watching all that from Germany, and then suddenly all this Connolly repertoire of Pope Benedict, which was just wonderful to see. The collaboration of Richard Connolly, James McCauley, Tony Newman, Roger Pride, and Father Ted Kennedy culminated in the publication of the Living Parish Hymnal. There's Richard up there too. And this hymnal sold over 1 million copies. It was state of the art, contemporary sacred music, and classics as well. And I still have an original edition. Look, Martin Cooke, 31 Pacific Parade, Manly, July 1967. I used this all my adult life until I went overseas to Munich. And I left it in the cupboard of St. Patrick's Church Hill, where I was choir master for 6 years. And when I was in Germany, I was always needing a hymn. And I said, if I only had my hymn. Then I asked Pastor some years ago, I said, Pastor, if you're going to the church, ask the organist, is my book still there? My hymn book in the cupboard. And unfortunately, it wasn't. And then I joined in Facebook. Facebook has some members. I joined this Australian Sacred Music group. And I was watching and I made a few comments. And the owner of this group said, oh, Mark, Christmas at the Opera House in 1983-84, when I was 15 years of age. And he said, I've got something of yours. And I said, what's that? He said, your hymnal. And he found it at a flea market or something. And he has sent this precious possession of my childhood back to me. And there it is. Isn't that wonderful?
Yes.
So I just thought I'd tell you that story. A favourite composition, commonly a composition of mine, is this Mass, Give Us Peace, which we sang in the 1960s here in Madrid. And I performed it on many occasions during theological studies with the Maristas in the late 1970s. It was particularly suited for solemn feasts and major occasions such as ordinations, and also as a simple Mass with the cantor and a congregation in the organ. This brilliant conception of a Mass that could be performed, as I've just said, was extended then to a full orchestra with brass strings. And it was very festive, and I've loved it to this day. And there it is there. Richard, we've gone through all those shots. With there was an LP as well. This period during and just after the Council was a creative and inspirational time for liturgical music. And Richard, together with his strengthened by James McCauley, has given the church a literal treasure trove of hymns which I have loved all my life. O Jesus Crucified, In Faith and Hope and Love, to mention just two. And my favourite on the hymn will be Caritas et Amor Deus Filius, where there is charity and love, there God will abide. Ladies and gentlemen, Richard Connolly is present with us this evening, and I'd like to give him a big welcome. And Tom thought we might sing with There Is Charity and Love. How those vocal cords, everybody? In good form? Let's have a go.
The pastor probably haven't finished yet. No.
Yeah, as many as you like, son.
You sound big enough, I'll put the trumpet out.
Yeah.
Over time, some of these swoon pieces.